Six reasons why I love making videos.
Six reasons why I got into creative storytelling. So one, passion. I got into cinematography because I had passion. I think I remember vividly when I was about 14, 15 years old. Yeah, I was sitting down in my house one day and I saw a movie made by Tyler Perry, and I loved the movie so much, and I fell in love with cinematics, history, creative storytelling. I told myself, wow, I would really want to go into cinematics. I just felt it was like a calling for me. It was like I was drawn to the screens. I was drawn to the stories. I was drawn to the cameras. I was drawn to everything, the sound, the gaffers, the cameras, everything. The actors and the directing also made me, it actually blew my mind away. So I was really drawn to that part. And I told myself that I really, really want to get into this. Like, this is what I was born for. This is what I really love, or really want to spend my life doing the rest of my life here. So I started off by making probably writing some these little stories. Then back then in church, be the director, bring people together and maybe act some little playlet, and it was actually turned out well. So gradually I told my parents about it. At first they didn't believe in it, and gradually they saw that I was actually growing into it and falling in love with it, and I think they had no choice but to support me. And by God's grace, passion has actually brought me to this point where I started creating documentaries for state governments, also for NGOs, and also for other organizations.
For me, it's the expression. You know, videos give you this room of expressing yourself. And I feel I'm a very expressive person, and I could be also very reserved and conservative when it comes to engaging a few conversations, especially with people I'm not very familiar with or strangers. But I become very expressive when I get very familiar and comfortable with you. And I feel that's something that very few people can give, but I always get it from my camera. You know, your camera is very calm and cool, just still looking at you, and you are expressing yourself. You are recording this moment of a high energy level. You're trying to communicate exactly what inspired that energy in you to the world out there. So expression is, well, top the list for me. Expression is one of the top reasons why I will want to make another video, and I'll make another video after I've made the video I plan to make. You see, expression is something that I personally love, because I have a lot of things to see and I can't wait to see these things. With the new evolution of social media, and people are just busy online with their phones and their computers, very few people have a good attention span. Most of us have a very short attention span. So what I see as a good thing to do is to actually record your thoughts in forms of videos and put it out there, where you could probably get someone to look at what you are doing. And supposing you don't get somewhere to look at it, you have to get very comfortable in front of a camera and record some of these thoughts, preserve some of these things you have to see. So that's a room for expression is the top reason why I started doing every of my visual content, photography, videography, everything, digital art, just every single thing that I do is because of the expression.
Creative storytelling, wow. So that part is what makes the whole cinematic reality show come to life, right? So creative storytelling has to do with good cameras, good sets, good lighting, good audio, and you actually have a good director, right? So I think those are the five basic things you need to make your creative storytelling come to light. All right, so first of all, as a director, whenever I get a project or a gig to do, probably wedding cinematography, first of all, when I ask my client for the location, the hotel we're going to be shooting at, where we'll be creating this story. So I go online, check out what and where we're supposed to do these videos. I go online, check out the hotel. The hotel is beautiful. Wow, I know, okay, this is what I need to bring for the gig. I need to get this. I need to get a drone, get this kind of cameras, get this kind of light. Either place is well lit, I would restrict the number of lights in our break.
One of the reasons why I love creating videos is for teaching. You see, whatever you teach, you become better at. As a matter of fact, he said, in order for you to learn something and become a true master of it, you have to, first of all, teach it. Learning how to do is, first of all, learning how to teach. So teaching has been a very exciting activity that I love doing, and I love sharing knowledge with those that are around me. I find out that videos is a very interesting way to express myself and share these ideas with people that are around me. Teaching be one of the top most priorities of why I began to do videos, and I continue to do these videos, and sincerely, I don't plan on stopping. I teach people what I know. I teach people what I want to learn better. I teach people because the way teaching works is that whatever you are saying, you are reacquainting it to yourself. So you hardly forget what you said. You hardly forget the things you said from your own lips. The words become more internalized. You know it like at the tips of your fingers because you've taught it. So the online space is a very good area for you to get to do some of these things. Whatever it is you want to do, those are your widest dreams. The internet is a blessing for you to be able to express this thing you've had in mind. So you want to be a filmmaker, you want to be a producer, you want to be a musician, here's your opportunity. You can shoot music videos, you can shoot full movies, even with phones. There are some phones that have very good cameras that can actually work. You can learn an editing software, try to figure it out, and just do what you want and put it out there. Yes, and the cool thing about all this now is that you can actually approach anybody after you've done this and say, okay, this is what I've done, and I'm a filmmaker or I'm a musician, and you have results to show for it. So I feel videos are just very priceless when it comes to learning and teaching, because as I said, in order for you to learn and become a master, you first of all have to start with teaching. So there is something you know that somebody out there needs, so just look for a way to carve out a niche and begin to express yourself, be it Instagram, be it Facebook, the best of which is YouTube. You could just put out your thoughts there, put out your expertise, you know, some of these things you know, you share these ideas, then you now find out that it's like a butterfly effect. Whatever you give will come back to you in hundreds of folds. You become far better and you become more knowledgeable.
Creative videography comes with lots of responsibility because I feel you have to do lots of takes, lots of writing, lots of directing. So doing videography is more challenging, but people don't get to see this because they just feel you just have to come your camera and then just position yourself at one location and then shoot. It doesn't work that way. You need to be attentive. It comes with lots of focus without distraction. It comes with lots of responsibility. It comes with lots of thinking. Like your mind needs to be focused on the people, the action, the food, the dance, what the master of ceremony is saying, what's going at the point, to pay attention to what they do. It's mind. It's mind taxing. Sometimes I just feel like running mad, you know what I'm saying? It's just crazy. It's crazy, trust me. Literally, like, stressed. It comes with lots of challenge. But where the big work is editing. That's where your creative skill comes in. You know, when you have a client and they don't give you what you want, you need to give them what they want from editing. So creative storytelling is so challenging, and sometimes I just want to cry after watching what I've done. Like now. I'm not crying literally, but I'm smiling, but I'm literally crying in my heart.
Yes, making videos will definitely pay your bills if you stay consistent on it and continue to improve yourself. You see, from visual effects to motion graphics to creation of CGIs and animation, visual content is just something that is so interesting. It's something that is in very high demand in the world. different production companies, cinematic companies, everybody is in need of a visual or a video maker, right? Someone that is very proficient with the whole video making process. And this is something that is very stressful as well as challenging. So there's a lot of room for those that want to dive into this industry. Those that want to create corporate videos, those that want to bring in creativity into the business space and get to run advert campaigns for different organizations and companies. So this is a very large room that will give you space for improvement as you continue to build on in your career as a video maker. So I feel it's going to pay your bills. You get to shoot different occasions like weddings, you get to shoot birthday parties, you get to even make just videos for your friends. Sometimes your friend can say, "Okay, I love the way you made your video. Can you just do similar stuff for me?" You say, "Okay, this is how much I'll charge you." All right. So even as you continue to pursue the passion, except if you want to do it entirely for the hobby part of it, the fun part of it. And I see a lot of people with very expensive gadgets shooting amazing videos for free. Okay, it's cool, but I feel businesses is something that everybody should be into, and a little extra income is not going to hurt. So you could get to charge for your creativity. Creativity is priceless. You could make a very beautiful shoot with your iPhone and it looks amazing. You know how to edit it and it looks beautiful. You charge, you place a fee on it. It will teach you about the business world, because the business is the holy grail of survival in the world. You need to understand how buying and selling works. You need to learn how to exchange value, and it will definitely encourage you to become better. You get more professional gadgets, you begin to go for bigger gigs, you begin to grow, you begin to get better, and it just pays the bills. And I love anything that gives me extra money, so I'll never stop making videos.